Welcome back to my channel. Today we're checking out Pirate Warriors 4. We just got the new DLC drop of the One Piece Film Red DLC. And today we're going to be checking out Uta. I'll go over her moves here in a second. And then we'll finish off on this playthrough on this map. So far, absolutely great character, I will say though. But let's get into the moves and see what she can do. First off, we got our taunt, which is pretty cute, but nothing that major for a taunt. And that's her square triangle combo. And then square square triangle. I really like the look of her moves. And then three squares into triangle. This one you hop on a musical note and you fly for a long time. Like, it lasts a long time. And then when you get to the end, she, like, swirls it up and does a bunch of damage. And then four squares into a triangle. Big front AoE attack. And then this is just her five squares. And then this is her triangle in air. That is her launching attack. And then her triangle explodes all of the drops that show up on the map when she attacks. And that's when you cancel out of a combo with a square. It does the firework thing. And this is midair, one square, one triangle. And then airborne, two squares, triangles. Does like missiles with musical notes. And then three squares midair into a triangle. And then four squares. And then the triangle goes into this big attack. And then just five squares. And then this is her one transformation ability. It turns her into a sky type. That's her square triangle attack. And then two squares into a triangle. Three squares into a triangle. This will mind control people and make them like dance around. And it finishes off with the attack. And that's four squares into a triangle. And then I accidentally used her one triangle ability. And that's just four or five squares. And then that was her triangle attack on the ground. And just her full force burst. And this is her first super attack. That one's actually really good. It doesn't look too amazing. And this one drops like a bunch of stuff, musical notes and stuff on the ground. And then if you press your triangle, it will explode them all. And then this super move, if you actually land it and hit the opponent properly, it will do a massive damage, I found. And this one is a good circle AoE attack. It's pretty good for breaking guards too. And then we have... Oh yeah, this one is like a big like beam burst attack type thing. And then she has a counter move. Get someone hit us here. Does a little attack with musical notes. It doesn't seem that good. Like, it, nothing major. And then this one is like a forward facing super attack. And then this one is like massive damage. I found that one very good so far. Kind of draws people in and then explodes them into the star. And that's her dash attack. She dashes on that same musical note. But that's it for her moveset. It's really good, and she's the only character I've played so far by the time I'm recording this. But I did two or three matches with her while I was like leveling her up and whatnot. But overall, just very fun character. Very flashy, good AoE damage, and... I haven't done anything crazy with her builds or anything yet, and she seems very good. She can also inflict status attacks in her one form when she kind of makes everyone dance. And they go off and then get hit in a big attack. I don't know if you use some of the skills, maybe you can make it last longer or not. That is something to test out. But overall, I think she'll probably end up being possibly my favorite character of the pack. Because just going in, she was the character I was most excited looking forward to. But I could see Shanks and Kobe both being really fun to play. Especially Shanks. And we'll see. I'll probably have either Shanks and Kobe's video up tomorrow. Or just Shanks and then do Kobe's the next day. We'll see how it works out. It was kind of a weird recording for this video because I had a doctor's appointment and I had to go to a different town. So it was a bit of a drive early in the morning. So I recorded all the footage and then I'm recording this now once I'm back. Man, this move where she like flies on the musical note and then spins around with it is so satisfying. But we also had just recently the new like first episode kind of Egghead, and then we got the new opening and ending, both very good. The opening is amazing. I mean, it has a bunch of spoilers for anime onlys, but the opening itself is really good, and the animation on the first episode, or the, I guess last episode, I think it was 1098, something like that, but it was really good. It was an awesome episode. And we got to, like, see some things more in depth. And, like, seeing the crew interactions again on the ship after being in Wano for so long was so nice. It was a nice change of pace. And I'm, so looking forward to the next arc. It's gonna be so good. Can't wait until we get to the point where, like, we can get characters and stuff from Egghead. In One Piece games. Although for One Piece it usually takes them forever to get like actual recent content into the games. I feel like Wano and like Whole Cake Island didn't took way longer than it should have to actually be put into games and stuff. And it's also hard because what do you gotta do when an arc's half over and takes like a year or more to finish? It's kind of crazy to deal with. That's another big plus side of getting movies for animes, is it lets like games and stuff for those series get a lot more content, because it's usually kind of dried up by a certain point and it's like hard to add more characters without just like being the same thing and the same characters. Like Dragon Ball really like does that and like uses their movies for game characters and stuff like that, and even old ones sometimes gets new stuff, mostly in mobile games, but like Xenoverse 2 still has like a lot of the old movie villains and stuff like that. But then we have Pirate Warriors, where we're missing some like arcs, big bads, and like some of the warlords and stuff, which is very sad. And I've noticed since playing Uta, because her ability where it like spawns like presents and gifts and stuff and musical notes on the ground and then she can explode them, works like how Perona did in Pirate Warriors 3 with her ghosts. She could like get them on people, and then after you've grouped a bunch of people up, you could like press your unique button. I think it was R1 or something like that on the Pirate Warriors 3. And then it would explode them all, and you could do, like, a clear massive area. But, yeah, it's sad we don't have, like, people from Thriller Bark and Skypiea, stuff like that. Just some of the more popular characters kind of just take over, especially with, I've noticed in, like, anime games, they kind of, certain characters usually kind of get left out for a couple games, and then they just don't really show up that often. But it's always a shame to lose characters in a roster. I think it's just because with Pirate Warriors 4 from 3, as we got like the aerial combat, so they couldn't just directly import moves anymore. So I think they just got a bit lazy on like the less popular arcs, like although I think even in Pirate Warriors 3 we didn't have like Horty Jones as a playable character, or like a lot of side characters, and I think we only had Rob Lucci from CP9, just like in Pirate Warriors 4. It's weird some of the characters they don't include, honestly, because I would love to play most characters in One Piece, actually, I like enough. A lot of the... Yeah, like most arcs, I like the characters that we got in them, and like the side characters and stuff. I especially liked Wano, like side characters. They didn't get to do a ton, which is kind of just a par for the course of a shonen, where the side characters kind of just really stick to the side and don't get to do much. But I am really excited to see all the side characters in Egghead finally be animated, and we finally meet a certain doctor after, probably 600 or 800 episodes since the first time he was referenced. I forget when the first time Vegapunk was referenced, but something I've been waiting for like, ever in the series. So just finally getting all this, like, things that just have been building up to forever and finally seeing is so awesome. The one thing I hate about watching series weekly is you can't just like binge, go through the entire story and like appreciate it all in one go. Because as much as I absolutely love all of the stuff that's going on in the manga at the moment, having to wait in between each chapter kind of kills the momentum a lot. And like we had a flashback for a lot of chapters, really good flashback, but at the same time you wanting to see what the other plot lines that were unfolding already. But I think it's been going pretty good, even for like weekly. I guess sometimes it's like a bit more. Oda's been taking some breaks, which I'm honestly fine with. Even in, you do have to like lose a bit of it, it's like, or like lose a bit of your momentum. I would still rather that than not get the series at all. It's just a shame how many like good manga there are that aren't even close to being finished. And at least now, instead of just ongoing forever, some series have been kind of ending and then getting like a sequel series with the new plot lines and whatnot. I just recently finished rewatching and then watching for the first time the final season of Fairy Tail, which it's not like a super amazing series or anything in my opinion, but it's one of the first series I watched when I got into anime, and I've been putting off watching the final season for so long, but I figured I'd do that before the the new anime season is starting. And then I think sometime this year Fairy Tail 100 Year Quest or whatever is gonna be starting, which I'm excited for, and I'll definitely be watching. But there's just so much to watch this season. I like wasn't gonna watch that much, but I kept like looking, and there was like more shit that was popping up that was like kind of piquing my interest, or like people I know were watching and like wanted me to watch. That like I have like so many ongoing shows at the moment, so just finished binging Fairy Tail, and then gonna catch back up with everything. But probably my favorite show right now, still going and still free ren. It's been so good. But I'm gonna give probably the first episode or so of like most shows this season a go, and then probably actually drop some stuff, which I rarely do. Like on my anime list, I have like 3 or 4 drop shows, something like that. I rarely do, but like I'm getting to the point where, like, there's so many sequels and new shows that I want to watch, and, like, I have such a big backlog now that I just can't get to everything, airing seasonally. So, I'm going to start dropping stuff that's, like, not super catching my interest, Like, I think I might drop Classroom of the Elite this season. I've watched the first two seasons, but, like, it was never the best. Like, when I watched the first season when it aired a long time ago, and I, like, enjoyed it a lot, but on rewatch and, like, going through the second season, it just wasn't as much for me as it was when I was a bit younger. But we'll have to see. I haven't even checked out the third season yet. We got two episodes out. So I might end up liking this season or what's going on with the characters. So we'll pick it up and see. But I also have to binge the first part of Blue Exorcist, because that's getting its third season. And I don't remember like anything from that show. I've watched way too much anime since last time I've seen it. So I'll probably be putting off watching the third season until at the end of the season, where I can get around to binge watching the first part. Because I think it's like the first 17 episodes are canon, and then the second season, and then you can go into the third season with all like the canon material. Because that's a weird series where it ended with a filler, which is always a shame when a series does that, and it's like not planning to do a full adaptation, but it's whatever. And we're about to kill Smoker here and be the mission. Yeah, that move is pretty satisfying when you can get at someone actually stuck in it. But yeah, absolutely loving Uta, and I will definitely have more videos out for this DLC in the coming days. But thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys all later. Peace.